Good morning, everybody. Illinois football ended their season on a high note with their second straight bowl victory. It was a roller coaster of a ride for Illini football this year. A 6-0 start and top 15 ranking that turned into a 500 campaign with Coach Ron Zook losing his job. But Illinois snapped their 84-day losing streak with a 20-14 victory over UCLA in the Kraft Fight Hunger Bowl. With a whole new coaching staff taking over next season, the Illini will look to carry their momentum into the new year.
Oh, I just can't wait till the 16th comes about. We get to meet as a team, talk about the future, talk about this feeling right now, leaving this bowl game and continuing to build from it.
We've been through some tough times, but you know, we've got an amazing belief in our locker room and each other. You know, I don't know who our whole coaching staff is going to be. You know, but to Coach Beckman and to all those coming in, we've got a bunch of fighters, and we're not going to quit. We're not going to give up.
And it was a busy Monday for the Big Ten. Monty Ball and the Wisconsin Badgers representing the Big Ten against LaMichael James and the Oregon Ducks. But it would be running back DeAnthony Thomas who would have a big impact in this one. Last play of the first quarter, Thomas breaks off a 91-yard run for the touchdown, the longest run in Rose Bowl history. Thomas would finish two carries for 155 yards and two TDs, but the Badgers would respond. Monty Ball, two-yard touchdown run. Ball finishes with 156 yards on 32 carries. Then before the end of the first half, Wisconsin recovers the Darren Thomas fumble for the score. This one was tied 28-all at the half. Wisconsin leads in the fourth quarter, but Oregon would score 10 unanswered points. Thomas finds Lavazier Tooney for the go-ahead TD. And in an odd ending, Wisconsin 25 yards away with one last chance, but Russell Wilson can't spike the ball in time. Oregon wins their first Rose Bowl since the 1916 season, beating Wisconsin 45-38. And in the Outback Bowl, Georgia would lead Michigan State 16-0 before the Spartans would respond. Down 27-20 with just 20 seconds remaining, they would score to tie the game and send this one to overtime. And after an interception by Kirk Cousins, Georgia with a chance to win it, but Blair Walsh misses the 42-yard attempt. We go to double overtime where both teams settled for field goals in double OT, sending this to a third OT. Dan Conroy hits the 28-yard field goal to put Michigan State ahead. And then Blair Walsh's 47-yard attempt blocked by Rashad White. Big Ten beats SEC. Michigan State wins the Outback Bowl 33-30 in triple overtime. Ohio State taking on Florida in the Gator Bowl down in beautiful Jacksonville, Florida. Special teams would be a problem for the Buckeyes. Where have we heard that before? After knotting it up at 7, Andre DeBose with the 99-yard kickoff return for the TD. And then Ohio State's punt is blocked, and Graham Stewart recovers it for the Gators. The Gators are victorious in the Gator Bowl. Florida beats Ohio State 24-17. Ohio State with its first seven-loss season since 1897. Nebraska taking on South Carolina down in Orlando. End of the first half. The Gamecocks looking for the Hail Mary. And wideout Alshon Jeffrey comes down with it for the score. Jeffrey finishes with four catches for 148 yards and a TD. Now things would get chippy between these two teams. Jeffrey and Nebraska defensive back Alfonso Denard would both get ejected for fighting. But South Carolina has the last laugh, winning the Capital One Bowl 30-13. And finally, in the Ticket City Bowl, a rough year for Penn State ends with a bad bowl loss. Casey Keenum, 29 of 45 for 380 yards and three TDs in the first half alone. Keenum finishes with 532 passing yards, surpassing Doug Flutie's 1982 record for the most ever against Penn State as Houston rolls to victory 30-14. And the NFL regular season is over, and that means it's Black Monday around the National Football League. In a surprising development, the Indianapolis Colts fired team vice president Bill Polian and his son Chris, the Colts general manager. In 14 seasons with Indianapolis, Polian's teams won 143 games, made the playoffs 11 times, and appeared in two Super Bowls. The Colts finished this season 2-14 and will have the number one pick in April's NFL draft. Coach Jim Caldwell has been retained at this time, but his position as head coach is still under review.
There is so much that goes into a decision like this. In the end, I think it is an intuitive decision where you feel that the time is right to make a change. And like I said, it's difficult because of the close relationship Bill and I have.
Raheem Morris out as the Tampa Bay Buccaneers coach. The St. Louis Rams ousting coach Steve Spagnuolo and general manager Billy Devaney. In three seasons with the Rams, Spagnuolo went just 10-38, including a league-worst 2-14 record this season. St. Louis will be turning to its fourth head coach in the last 5 years. The team is set to interview former Tennessee Titans head coach Jeff Fisher later this week. And it's the one day a year where hockey goes outdoors. The 2012 Winter Classic from Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia as the Flyers took on the New York Rangers. Philadelphia had 1-0. NHL points leader Claude Giroux with the goal to put the Flyers up 2-0. But the Rangers, they would storm back. Two goals from enforcer Mike Rupp and then their prized free agent signing from the offseason, Brad Richards, scores the go-ahead goal. But this one would come down to a penalty shot. Henrik Lundqvist denies Danny Briere, and the Rangers win the 2012 Winter Classic in a great game to take control atop the Eastern Conference, winning by a final score of 3-2. And one final NFL note, former Illini running back and Pittsburgh Steeler Rashard Mendenhall will miss the playoffs after tearing his ACL in the team's Week 17 matchup against Cleveland. That's it for sports. Have a great morning, everybody.